Welcome to steel making course. What are the steel plants you know and where are they located in India? Let us see few plants and let us know what is happening inside these steel making plants, how this liquid pig iron is produced from the blast furnace, and the plants which uses this production process in Vizag steel plant, Tata steel plant, Jindal steel works plants, and how do you produce this pig iron into the liquid steel using LD converter in the same steel plant such as Vizag steel plant, Tata steel plant and steel works plant. As the name suggests that it is a converter, it converts iron into the steel. And the full form of LD is L stands for Linz, D stands for Donawitz. These are the main cities where this particular process of converting iron into the steel was initiated by a few scientists in 19th century. And how do you convert this steel into the alloy steels form, special steels, based on the application, how do you do? It requires further refining units such as remelting furnace, vacuum furnace, ladle furnace. If you need to reduce oxygen, nitrogen levels and carbon levels further to low to the form of 2 decimal or 3 decimals, you need to go for the vacuum furnace treatment. If you want to add some more alloying elements to make it into the alloy steels, you need to add alloying elements in the ladle furnace. That is why these refining units have very important role in the steel plants. It is a part of the steel plant process. And coming to the hot metal, this steel is assumed as a hot metal shaped into the semi-finished products. As the name suggests that semi-finished products, these forms are billet form, bloom form and slab form are produced using continuous casting operations, which was the end process of entire steel plant. And these semi-finished products are further processed using manufacturing units which are called as ancillary plants located in and around steel plants, which are mainly called as the thermomechanical unit operations such as rolling and forging, extrusion, etc. It produces in the form of plate, rod, sheet. And coming to the next, entire steel plant layout operation, this pig iron is produced by blast furnace. As we studied in the iron production, these are the raw materials, and produced from this blast furnace liquid pig iron is further as a raw material for the LD converter, steel converter. And this steel converter gives for the steels. If you need some unit operations, refining operation, you use ladle for the refining. And after this ladle furnace, continuously the casting operations are carried out to produce in the form of slab, billet, bloom. And these slabs and blooms are converted further in the form of using mechanical operations, thermomechanical operations, which are located in and around the steel plant, which are called as ancillary steel plants, in the form of plates, small thin rods and large length rods, large diameter rods. And there are other operations. You can continuously cast the various semi-finished products using, instead of LD converter, you can use electric arc furnace. The raw material for electric arc furnace, either you can use solid form of pig iron, which is called as a sponge iron form, combination of steel scrap or combination of pellets, and produced in the form of steel form, steel rods. These are fed into the, and by using continuous operations, these are produced. These are taken into the ancillary plants. Final step is these forms are very much suitable, which are called as the final products. You can use for the marine engineering, shipbuilding up, and the top cover of the car, and musical instruments, small thin wires using the pelletic steels, and suspension bridges and train tracks are used to produce or converted the these particular blooms and semi-finished products. Now let us know about the few steel plants located in India, starting from Rashtriya Ispat Nigam Limited, which is also called as a Vizag Steel Plant, Vishakhapatnam Steel Plant, as the brand appears in the steel products Vizag Steels. It is pride of steel, and you will see in the products like these marks, which are called as a trademarks and watermarks in the their products, in the form of rod, sheets, pipes, cubes, various things are produced. And the other things, Tata Steel plant also is having blast furnace, LD converter. Finally, it gives the continuous casting products and further ancillary plants. All the things are located in and around Tata Steel plants in Jharkhand. Mainly this particular steel plant is located in Jharkhand. Coming to the Jindal Steel Works, these plants are located in Haryana and Maharashtra mainly. And this also products various range of products, starting from the rod, tubes, wires, many of the things. This is the other plant in India, SR Steels. These are mainly located in Gujarat. This also produced various range of the products, starting from the rod, plate, sheet to, it is also having the blast furnace, and also it has the LD converter, steel process, ancillary plants, all those things in this particular things. Coming to the Atibir Steel Plant, many of our students are placed and still working in this Atibir Steel Plant, which is located in the Jharkhand state. It has blast furnace, quite good facilities. It has extended to the ancillary plants and LD converter, steel process and electric arc furnace. And in the steel Jindal Steel Plants, there is a very large facility of electric arc furnace facility, which uses raw material as ferro alloys. And coming to the, there is a large scale of industries which was taken into the one umbrella, which was called as a Steel Authority of India Limited. The main branch is located in Maharashtra. The large range of the products are produced, from the train tracks, parallel beams, building construction material, many things. Now I am going to talk about this umbrella of plants, subdivided plants. One of the plant is Bhilai Steel Plant, which was located in the Chhattisgarh state and which has large facilities. The another plant is Bokaro Steel Plant, Bokaro district in Jharkhand. And the other plant is Durgapur Steel Plant, which was located in the West Bengal state in Calcutta city. And coming to the Rourkela Steel Plant, which was located in the Orissa state. All these particular plants have the good amount of facility of semi-finished products and pig iron production plant, steel plants, alloy steel plants, electric arc furnace, many of the things. I request the many of the students to go through more and more detail about these steel plants. What are their products? How do they produce? What are the operations it uses specifically? And plant to plant, how it varies? What are the plants are here and what was not in the other plant? One need to know, all the students supposed to know, that is one assignment to the students. And going to the Iron and Steel, Indian Iron and Steel Company Limited, which was located in the Jharkhand, it has many facilities. And Alloy Steel Plant, it has located in the Durgapur, West Bengal state. And Chandrapur Ferro Alloy Steel Plant, which has electrical arc furnace connected to this particular things. These are the variety of alloy steels are produced, which was located in the Maharashtra. And coming to the refractories are stabilized, or which fabrics supposed to be used for the various steel plants, are produced in this particular industry, Refractory Company Limited, which was a part of the SAIL, Steel Authority of India Limited, which was located in the Chhattisgarh state. Coming to the consultancy, it provides the consultancy for people in with respect to the SAIL Limited. It can be provided, if it has been produced only pig iron, it can provide the consultancy to produce the alloy steels and special steels for many of the other plants. This is the overall summary of Indian steel plants in and located. These are the public sectors and private sectors. Jindal Steel Works, Ispat Steel Plants, Hisar Steel Plant, Tata Steel Plants, and there are many steel plants and induction furnace based steel plants are located. As a knowledge one need to have about these particular plants. And now let us know about the steel production in this particular academic year. In May 20, the steel production was, if you take 64 countries, the World Steel Association says that around 148.8 million tons is produced, which is kind of a decrease rate when you compare with the May 2019. And this particular decrease is mainly because of this pandemic situation of COVID-19. One need to notice this particular point. And this is overall statistics starting from December 2019 to May 2020, entire world. This particular bar chart gives you what is the production in million tons, maximum to 150 million tons. As I said, that average 148.8 million tons. This is compared to with respect to the old in December 2019. This is old average steel production, whereas this particular thing, blue color or light blue color, this particular color suggests that this is the statistics of rest of the worlds. ROW is rest of the world produced this much, and only China produced this much amount of the steel. In terms of percentage compared to entire steel world production is this much. This is a grayscale gray line, and this particular light blue line gives rest of the world percentage. This is the China production plant percentage. Now let me conclude this particular lecture.